Your Excellencies, distinguished representatives, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It's my great pleasure to host this reception in celebration of the Spring 2022, a chairman of Taiwan People's TPP. I would like to express my sincerest welcome to all of you here today, and wish everyone a happy and vigorous new season of the year. First of all, I would like to officially introduce the Taiwan People Party on this occasion, our debut to the audience of international community and the media. As you may be aware, 47 years ago, Taiwan began to witness the democratization process, which could be regarded as the first wave of quiet revolution in this country. However, as time went by, certain political, social, and energy economic problems have been gradually leaving the country idle, and they are all urging us to answer the call to take the second wave of quiet revolution into action, which highlights structuring fellowship society and refining state governance. It is in this context, Taiwan People's Party was established in 2019, less than 3 years ago. TPP symbolized the promotion of the political ideology to be Taiwan-named and people-oriented, with a hope to offer Taiwan's electorate better choices, not only in election, but also in the process of effective achieving Taiwan value. Speaking of which, I would like to announce that TPP will recommend certain young and professional candidates to join officials and councillors elections of all levels of Taiwan's local government later this year. They are going to represent a new generation of Taiwan's people to revisit their genuine values. And they will carry the mission to change Taiwan political landscape, long-term monopolized by the pan-green and the pan-blue camps. For the first quarter of the year of the Tiger, the whole world has been simultaneously facing two wars, and they both have caused large casualties. First, the war is a pandemic. Thus far, nearly 500 million people worldwide have contracted COVID-19, and more than 6 million of them lost their lives. The second one is the ongoing Russia's invasion of Ukraine and its aftermath. Thousands of people were killed and millions of Ukraine refugees have fled into neighboring states. And all of these have collected from a current version of Exodus, but without Moses. During the last 4 weeks, I have represented Taipei City Government to virtually join the meeting of Pact of Free Cities in addressing assistance to refugees fled from Ukraine. This meeting was summoned by Mayor Rafael Trzaskowski of Warsaw, and Taipei has contributed €300,000 to help refugees' medical and humanitarian needs. With regards to our battle against the COVID-19 pandemic, for the last 2 years, Taiwan's people and residents have demonstrated a world-renowned level of discipline so that we could effectively prevent and control the spread of the virus. And thanks to timely vaccine donation at an early stage by the United States, Japan, and certain other friendly countries of the European Union, so that certain vulnerable Taiwan people could be vaccinated at the time. When the world is complicatedly challenged by the ongoing pandemic, the restructuring of global supply chains, inflation on the rise, and the severe US-China competition, and the more frequent broad confrontation between countries with different ideologies, Taiwan in particular has to employ a diverse, flexible, and pragmatic approach to comprehensively review and manage our international relations. As the situation of Taiwan's threat is at stake, we need to work with all the stakeholder countries in this part of the world so that we can co-assure peace in the Taiwan Strait and the stability of the Indo-Pacific region. Ladies and gentlemen, 33 years ago, at the closing ceremony of Taipei World University 8, I said, Taipei is a city of glory, and Taiwan is a story of success. Today, I would like to assure you, ladies and gentlemen, the Taiwan People's Party is a new hope, which calls for Taiwan better security, prosperity, and sustainable development with unparalleled enthusiasm and commitment. Let's work together, and we won't let you down. May God bless you. May God bless Taiwan people, and God bless the Republic of China. Thank you.
各位观众朋友，大家好，我是学姐黄静莹。比起熊赞，我更需要你们帮我按个赞。一年中我最爱的月份就是你的订阅，请帮我们按赞、订阅、开启小铃铛。学姐爱你哦，啾咪！